Because God's going to speak to you and tell you some stuff. But you gotta open your mouth. You gotta stir up the gift in you. Stir it up by praying in tongues. This is a Holy Ghost church. And God wants to do something to you. And anybody in his age, I'm talking to you too. Okay, receive it. Receive what I'm telling this guy. Receive it. Pray in tongues. Prophesy to yourself. Speak over yourself. Man, God's got plan for you. Let me tell you something. Girls are not going nowhere. They're going to be around. So if you delay and cool it down, slow down, you don't have to be on this phone all the time. Talking to somebody, man. You talk to God. You could rap with God. You get into the Word. You get quiet sometime. And He'll talk to you. Some of you need to put your phone down and let God talk to you. You're too busy. You guys are too much occupied in your mind. You go to a restaurant, you're on the phone. How can you hear God? Some of you shut the phone down. And you'll hear Him tell you that He loves you. You talk and say, don't go there. Don't go. Do this. Listen. God's got a plan for you. I'm not trying to put you on the spot, okay? I condemn you. I just want to encourage you. But sometimes, just get quiet before God. And He'll tell you stuff, man. Because He wants to do something in you, man. You're gonna do something for your family. Just like God used me to get my family out of Jamaica. He wants to do something in you. I don't know what it is. I can't tell you, but you'll know. You'll remember this night. What is it, the 4th of November? Is this the 4th? You'll remember this night. That God wants to touch you. Amen? Amen. Folks, please, don't get jealous when I minister to people. I just have to go by the Holy Spirit. So there's some of you feel like, brother, come to me. No. Please, don't do that. Let me flow. Like I said, if I'm ministering to somebody through the Holy Spirit, you could take some of it and say, it's for me. He may be speaking to Francis, but he may be talking to you. Yes. Young lady, I just want to pray. What's your name? Stand up. All of you. Rose. All of you beautiful Rose. You're 22? You're young. You finished college? Huh? You're senior, okay, in high school. So you have been to college. You find a college that you want to go to? You have one that you really like to go, but it's far out of your range? No, what I mean far, I mean financially. You know what? God wants to trust him. My son, he went to Columbia. That was far out of my reach. But I trust God. You gotta give God something to work. You gotta aim for something. If you don't aim for nothing, you won't get nothing. But you have to aim. Believe, trust God. Trust Him, okay? And see yourself going to college. Even though men look tough for your parents, but God is an awesome miracle worker. You hear me? Amen. And you have a phone? You have a cell phone? Go easy with your cell phone when it comes to your study, your tests. You know, sometimes just when you have someone during school week, shut your phone down. And just keep focus on the books. Focus on the books. Because you're not going to be there. It's just, you're just going through. So just, I'm talking to you young people, cut the phone out sometime and focus, okay? Give God something to work on. Amen. God, Father, can I pray for you? Father, I just pray for this young sister and Francis and all the young people. I just pray for them. If you just bless them, protect them, Father. Favor them. Open doors for them. In Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord won't tell me that He's pleased with you. Stand up, young lady. You did a good job tonight. Were you there singing? Were you singing tonight? You did a good job. Do you think you didn't do a good job? Be honest to me. Do you think you didn't do a good job? Huh? You did a good job. It's pleased with you. Because you know what? You do it from your heart. You're not trying to look fame. And continue to do that. And God will open up doors for you. He's pleased with you. Okay? Give God your best. All singers here, give God your best. Are you in school? Not yet. You're about to. Can I pray for you? Father, just pray for her. Bless her. Help her, Father. Help her in whatever she's going through. Help her, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Only you can open doors for her. And we trust that you'll do it for her. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let us pray for your young man right there. All the young people, stand up. Stand up, you young people. I'm just going to land on this young man. And I'm just like laying on your father. I pray for all these young people. I pray healing over their bodies, protection, favor. Bless them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. You guys can sit down. Hallelujah. How much time I got, Pastor? How much more time I got, sir? How much time I got left? Well, how much more time I have left? Okay, thank you. What is 10 minutes? Don't tell me. Are you guys been blessed?
Yes,
I'll tell you, the weather in Accra is right. To you guys, it's like no big deal, but I came out from the fridge to the heat. So, anyway, as I said in England, I am pouring out. Hallelujah. You guys are a blessing. Hallelujah. Yes, let's go back to Ephesians. And to know the love of Christ, which passeth knowledge. Your mind. It's in your mind can comprehend you. And that's what's so awesome. To just get that revelation. When the enemy comes to you to deceive you or to lie to you that God don't love you and to put condemnation, your mind cannot comprehend, like, man, can God still love me? Yes, He does. He loves you. 1 John 4:18. He said, there's no fear in love, but perfect. Jesus' perfect love, it casts out fear. Because fear a torment. Either fear is not made in perfect love. Folks, when you really have that revelation of the love of God, the good news of God love you, when the enemy attack you, maybe in your body, in your finances, or whatever, and you may maybe mess up you, and the devil like, man, God not going to, no, because He's in love with me. You don't have to fearful of, is God going to come through? Is God going to give me this building? No, perfect love. You don't have to be fearful like, is God really going to give us a building? Yes. And they feel like, who do you know is going to give you that? Because He loved me so much. You know, when I was going through Bible college, and I have some challenge with my tuition, I didn't know I was going to pay my tuition some days, because I was going through some stuff. But one thing I had to tell God, it was like, I was in my room just worshiping God, and I just like, how much you love me. I do that, folks, this is a lie. I live this. But I said one time, and it was kind of challenging, I said, because you love your boy, you can't get away from me. You love me so much, it's going to pay. Everything's going to take away because you love your boy. You love me so much. You know you can't get away from me. You know that. You know that. You know you can't get away from me. Some of you are like, do you talk to God like that? Yes. Because, folks, you got to get it from up here to here. When you talk, you hear yourself. And because He loved me, I said, because you love me. You love your boy, Herbert. Yes, because he told me something, that Herbert, chill. Cool. Sometimes pastors, I didn't minister something, you look at the finances, your bank account, and you say, oh, Lord, are we going to pay this bill? And it challenged you. But you have to say, Lord, because you love me, everything. And I just want to tell you, brother, don't let nobody intimidate you with their giving. And if people leave, let them leave. Don't try to figure out why they leave. Or, no. Don't let nobody take the offering like some big givers. Don't let them try to feel like they can pimp you to do what? No. I have some rich for millionaire. Like I told you the other day, there's a brother, I went to a church, a small church, and one guy blessed me $10,000. But then he come back and want me to prophesy to him. And I'm like, I've got nothing to tell. I said, you need to do this and do that. And he said, say the Lord. I have money, I'm going to let him control me. Because God loves me, he's my father. He take care of me, he's my source. You're not my source, Jesus is my source. I never tell this man, so listen, I can only come to your church if you give me this cities, this so much cities. No. Did I tell you that, sir? I didn't tell you. I want to be a blessing to you. God is my source. I didn't tell you. God is my source. So God is going to be your source and nothing else. And don't sugarcoat it. I was telling Pete, there's another brother who was giving me to my ministry. Every month, they'll give me $1,000. Every month, they'll send me a check to Robert Johnson Ministry. And one day, he said, I told him I'm going to Africa. He sent me some legalistic chart. Those charts tell you, well, God, you're going to hell if you don't know Jesus, and la la. And he sent me a bunch of them and said, oh, take them to Africa. And my wife, Evelyn, said, are you serious, sir? Are you going to take them to Africa? Those legalistic. She said, you better throw them away. So I said, you know what? I can't because I want to buy Bibles over there. And I gave it to another ministry. And he said, what are you going to do now? Because I'm going to go preach. And this. He said, tell them about Jesus. They're going to hell. I said, no, I'm not doing that. Man, the following month, no checks. I'm like, really? No checks? I said, I'm going to Africa. He said, well, I'll see what I could do. And the Lord said, are you new to him or me? Yeah, sister. I said, no. And it took him a while. Folks, I'm still talking about the love of God. Rely, trust in God. And it took a while. He didn't send me nothing. Then he finally started to send me some check money. And he see that I take a stand. I'm not going to look to him. He's not my source. And he said, brother, I was not Peter. Well, pray for me, but I'm going to send you. Things is kind of tough. But I'm like, man, you're not my source. God is my source. Because he loves me. And there's more people, you know, try to manipulate me, you know, like the one because, you know, use money. I'm like, dude, for real? Psalms 23 said, the Lord is Herbert Shepherd. I shall not want the Lord. Let's look at it. I'm almost kind of sorry. Let's look at it, folks. Some of you is in ministry. You need to listen to this. Psalms 23. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord. Don't even move yet. Just get that revelation. He said, the Lord. He didn't say man. He didn't say you're big givers. He said, the Lord. David said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want of anything. He takes good care of me. The Lord. And you have to know that he is your Lord. I mean, he said, the Lord is present there now. My shepherd. A shepherd takes good care of the sheep. I believe your pastor look up to you guys. A good shepherd will make sure the sheep is taken care of. So the Lord is mine. That's love. And 6 said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Listen, folks, When he said, I will dwell in the house. The Amplified Bible said, I will live. It's like the present. It means present. We have an Amplified Bible. Let me see the Amplified. It's mean present. It's mean dwell in the house. No, you will be in its present. Huh? In this, what is it? Read this up.
Surely goodness and mercy and unfailing love shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell forever throughout all my days in the house and in the presence of the Lord.
Amen. The present. Jesus is with you always. You constantly before him. You know, Isaiah 40, I think it's 4:6-16 said, you know, he tattooed him with his hand. Thank you, fantastic. Isaiah 46, let me go. I think it's 4:6. No, I don't think it's 4:6-17. He said, in his hand is in part, in, what is it, fantastic? He's, in palm you, in the palm of his hand. He's like, engrave you. What is it? It's 4:6. Oh, 4:7. Let me see. Sorry. 15. I want you to see this, folks. Let's pray in tongues. Pray in tongues for a second, folks. 49:16. 16. Amen. 49:16. Read it for me, sir.
See, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are ever before me.
Amen.
Amplified things.
Behold.
Indeed, I have inscribed a picture of you on the palms of my hand.
That's love. You know, we sing this song as a young kid. In his hand, we got the whole world. In his hand, folks. I was singing that song in the note till one day he showed me that. God is so in love, he wants to see you every day. God's been in the tattoo business before tattoo become popular. And he engraved you. That's how much he loved you. And he looked at you and said, wow, I am so pleased with you, Philip. I'm so pleased. I'm in love with you. And it will never fade. Love for you. So stop beat yourself up and feel like, am I pleasing God? How many of you today believe that you are pleasing God? You are pleasing and lift your... Sister, are you pleasing God? Do lift up your hand. Listen to me, folks. Are you pleasing God? No, why you didn't put it behind? I said, if you believe you are pleasing God, lift up your hands. If all of you believe that you are pleasing God, put your hands up. If you believe that. You believe that? Yes. Some people can't say that they're pleasing God because they're looking at their past. You are pleasing God. God is pleased with you. Amen?
Amen.
He's in love with you. And tonight, when you go to bed, I want you to say, Lord, thank you. Close your eyes tonight and just say, thank you for loving me. And I thank you. You're going to experience the love of God right there. You're going to have a good sleep tonight because you're going to know the person of God is going to touch you tonight and he's going to start telling you that he loves you. God is in so much in love with you. Father, I thank you for your people. I thank you for this word. I thank you for the anointing in my life. Thank you, Father, for this message of your unconditional love, the good news. Thank you. It's through relationship with people, with him, through relationship with you, Father, that we could. Let me come to the conclusion in Jesus' name. My conclusion, you must have a revelation of the love of God through his word with the help of the Holy Spirit, who will guide you and teach you the Father's love. I highly encourage you to pray for this life-changing revelation. You can read Ephesians 1:17-21, you know, your daily prayer. all the time. Ephesians 3:16. Amen. Can I pray for you? Father, Father, I thank you that they're blessed, they're protected, favor over them, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord God, you start to open up their eyes of their understanding, to know you more. I just thank you, in the name of Jesus. If you are not certain of your salvation, if you should leave this earth tonight, where would you spend eternity? I want to know by lifting up your hands. If you don't know Jesus as Lord of your life, you don't have this relationship. You feel like you push away Jesus for a while and you just come into church, you know, the do's and don't, just to make your family feel good. You just come. You don't want to, but you come. I want you to come up right now. Let me pray with you to encourage you to get back with your Father's love. If you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking in tongues, I want you to lift your hands. You need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. If you desire to be in ministry and you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, you won't be effective in your ministry without the power of the Holy Spirit. So if that's you, stand up and come up here. I see the hands. Come up here.
I want that chance now. Pastor, what can? I know Pastor don't mind now. Go from this me up in him. Obaba umpayama.
You need the Holy Spirit.
Usher, please have them come forward.
Yes, Usher, come and prayer minister. I'm going to take them to be filled, but I'll pray with them first. Yeah. Church, 1987, a friend of mine told me about the Holy Spirit. I said, Holy what? He said, are you filled with the Holy Spirit? I said, no, Holy what? No. Man, my life changed when I got filled with the evidence of speaking in tongues. And I want to encourage you. When you